Hi everyone. Just thought I'd make a quick video on how to use these new Google Plus YouTube comments for people who are not quite aware of how it all works, just to clear up much of the confusion. To access your Google Plus profile and you are on YouTube, click the picture icon in the top right and it will say either page or profile. Or if you are outside YouTube, click the picture icon in the top right and click view profile. So here's my profile. I can edit my info on the About tab if I like, as well as change my name by hovering over it. But if I come up here to the top left, I have a variety of options. If I go to Pages, I can see any page I have set up. I am using a personal profile under my name, so I have no pages. If you do not wish to use your real name, you would create a page. A page must have a profile behind it. So if I create a page for something, that page would not exist without my personal profile. If you are familiar with Facebook, it works exactly like that. You have a personal profile of yourself, then there are pages of public figures, businesses, and other sorts of things. To tell if someone has a profile or page simply depends on the text that is displayed on their profile when you have not added them to your circles. Right in this area, it will say add to circles. That means it is a personal profile. If it says follow, it is a page. Your personal profile or any page created can be linked to a YouTube channel. So if you want a specific display username, create a page for it, and then connect that page to your YouTube profile. If you come up here and go to settings, you can access all the Google Plus settings like who can send you notifications, email settings, and when I scroll down here, you can change profile related settings, including one to disable your profile from appearing in search results. Now back over in YouTube, here viewing comments on my latest video. I always appear a first to myself, but technically the top comment is this hateful one right here. Oh yes, I love this one being at the top. But before we get to that, if I want to comment, I can also share it to Google Plus if I like. I'll talk about this in a moment. But I can also change the privacy settings. By default, it is public, but if you want to choose specific people or circles, you could do that here. Also, if you click on this icon, you can choose if you want to disable replies and reshares on your comment. All comments prior to when the system was implemented, November 6, 2013, are not able to be replied to or voted on. This is because a Google Plus post was not created for them and thus cannot be replied to. It would be great if this was fixed at some point though. However, if you want to reply to a specific user and perhaps are unable to, in the comment box, type plus and then the username. So for example, when I start typing my name, I see it here. Be sure to type slowly or it will not bring up this box and will not work properly. After I see it, I can click on it and it will turn blue. If it does not turn blue like this, then you did it wrong and need to start again. Now on to comments. All comments that are made are individual Google Plus posts. As you can see, I have three thumbs up on my post here that is blank saying that I shared it to Google Plus. Thumbs up and down work differently. A thumbs up is actually a plus one now. The number is showing the number of people that plus one the post. These people could have plus one the post on Google Plus. If I click on the date here, I get taken to the actual Google Plus post. People who have plus one'd may have wanted to like the video, but instead plus one of the post that was blank as shown here in the comments section. Now let's talk about why this comment is the top comment. Notice how it has one thumbs up. That doesn't matter. It is at the top because of the replies it has. It could be voted down by 10 people and it would not change its position as top comment. Hopefully this will be fixed at some point as well since people have been spamming this way. But anyway, to tell if the person has shared the comment on Google Plus or not is by the date link. When I hover over the date or just click on it, the URL it takes me to is google.com, meaning that they shared it to Google Plus. Now let's look at some of these other comments. This one is the same. Now notice this one's URL is youtube.com. This is because this user did not share with Google Plus, and if I click on the date link, it will only take me to the video and not the Google Plus post of that comment. Now let's click on the date for this disrespectful comment. As you can see, it takes me to the Google Plus post for that comment. I can see all replies. If you notice, you can also see the number of plus ones each reply has. If I click on that number, I can see the people who plus one the comment. On YouTube, it shows as thumbs up, but it's actually a plus one. Now, if I click on this arrow icon in the top right of the post and click View Post Activity, I can see all activity on this comment. I can see who commented and who actually plus one the comment. Now the confusing part. If someone is on Google Plus and they stumble upon this post and watch the video and like it and say, oh, I'll plus one this video, they are not actually plus one-ing the video, they are plus one-ing the comment. That is where confusion sets in. I can imagine many people plus one-ing posts of comments instead of the video. Just like my post here. It has three plus ones, probably all from Google Plus, from people who thought they were plus one-ing the video, not the blank comment. So I hope this video helped clear up some confusion with this new commenting system. I think once people learn how to use it and some of the bugs are worked out, it's not going to be too bad. But who knows? We'll see. Thank you for watching.